Welcome back, everybody, to buying Pharos Lockstones from a hag.
Thank you kindly.
And now that that's done, we're going back to the Bastille and we're going to approach it from t'other side. Because, yeah, we've got a lot of stuff left to do in the old Bastille, but I figure we can pretty much do most of it in one big sweep through the opposite end of the level. So we'll try doing that. See how we get on. So first up we've got this chap and his mate over there. Can we deal with that guy? Do we need to deal with that guy? Oh, there's oil barrels up here as well. That's not fun. And yeah, it looks as though we can't quite lock onto that dude. We've locked onto someone down below by the look of it. Although that may also have been Lulu just knocking my mouse off onto the floor like an awful little cow. Thanks for that, babe. Now, we'll drop down and grab the loot that lurks over here. Nice. Worth it. And now we can go and explore this lower level where we could have gone down the ladder to get to, but we didn't. And if we sneak into here, look where we are. Oh, come on. I hate you.
I know where that lives.
Son of a gun. But yeah, we'll pop back out. We'll explore the old area over here. And maybe a dude will drop down to say hello. I'm not sure if he's going to, or if they're going to lurk up there and just... Yeah, that guy's just going to lurk. What if we do this? Hello, friend. Well, just die, thank you. Hello, dog. Excellent. Oh, hello, dog. I thought we were done. Why aren't you dead? Thank you. Okay. Another dog.
They're everywhere!
Right. Dog's done. Guy up there. A whooshing sound from behind us that you might have heard. Because, yep, there's a pursuer. Oh, God. And now we've got two enemies to deal with. Isn't that great?
I'll tell me, man, on thee.
And now we're stuck in a thing. Also not great. Ah, come on. Just die already, thank you. Right. Now we can focus. Which means, of course, I just stopped talking. I was going to make a point earlier as well about how... Whoops. I was going to make a point how Medulla feels different to Firelink Shrine because of the way you can just teleport back to it whenever you wish. Feels more like a home bay, like a staging post than a home. Because that is one thing I miss with the whole teleport, is the whole going out on a big adventure and then finally getting back home and being like, yes, I'm here. But I do also approve of the feeling that you get of, right, I can make my plans now. Oh god, I'm out of Estus.
No, okay.
You can stay back until I've finished healing, please. Oh, come on, how did that hit? Verticals aren't supposed to track like that. This is nonsense. Oh, cheeky. Just avoid that one, thank you. He's not doing his big jumpy swoop, which gives you an opportunity to get hits in. Maybe it's because of the confined space. It's kind of interesting fighting him in all these different locations.
I've got it here.
And down he goes. This is not a great deal to explore in this direction. There is a dog though, which I'd forgotten entirely about, as you can see. And there is a chest. And a bonfire through that crack in the wall. And an Estus Flower Chask, grand. More of those are always welcome. And now, any more dogs over here, or did they all come over and say hello? Nice. So let's crack open this gate and get back to our old bonfire. Ah, come on. Sloppy play, but it's the kind of sloppy where you know you're right next to the bonfire, so it's fine. Now, is it actually easier to go from this bonfire, or would it be easier to go back to the old one? Because you've got a lot of dogs to get through over here. But then again, you can sneak up on them, so that helps. Duh, these cameras. These tight angles. Oh yeah, these guys are on the ground now, because all this is busted. Lovely. Where am I hearing this dog? Definitely hearing a doggo somewhere. It matters not.
Here I am.
There he is. Excellent. Right, so now we'll explore this lower section that we got invaded in last time. Oh, piss you. Why you gotta be like that? Oh, we've got souls over here as well. Lovely. I'd quite forgotten about that. Duh. I'll take the trade. Nice. Decent number of them. Now, lad on the roof. Now in Vanilla Souls, this rock brought up a cage with like five dudes in it, I think. Let's see what happens in Scholar. Yeah, there's quite a few of them. And they're probably going to kill me, so... Can we get up here quick? Nice. Can we have a sup? We can. This guy's noticed us. Not a problem. That was unexpected. And... Let's see, can we snipe these lads? I'd like it if we can. Sweet. Now, what about you? There's an explodey barrel in your way. You still gonna shoot? Whoops. Lock onto the right target, thank you very much. And down it goes. Now we've got a lad up here who's gonna drop down and say hello. And we're gonna try and backstab him, but the main thing is I was trying to avoid touching those barrels. Ooh, heavy crossbow, very nice.
Hey, that's champion.
But yes, we need a firebomb. Let's pop it on the old inventory, just to be sure. Now, let's go to full health just to be on the safe side, because this could get exploding.
Hey!
Sweet. And what do we find in our new room? Archdrake robes, nice. But did that cage that we bought up from the well bring us any treasure? Of course it did. That's the Wanderer set. How does that compare? So what are we looking at? 19 on that.
A lot of boring math later.
Yeah, the leather set actually, apart from the hat, the leather set provides more defense, I think. But what the hey, costume change is fine. And now we'll go up this here ladder here and grab the treasure. And now we can follow that swordsman's lead and drop down here. But in this room we find another lockstone spot. So let's give that a go. And we can see a nicely lit room now with a chap on the ceiling. Not so bad. Now, we've got chests in here. And we've got hidden swiping. This might be a soul vessel. I'm sure there's one behind a lockstone somewhere. Hey! So we could use that to respec if we wanted to. Maybe we'll need to at some point. I don't know. Now, is it mostly dex-related items in here, like twin blades and parrying daggers? Yeah. Yeah, twin blades are cool. Dual wielding twin blades is a fun build. What's in this one though? A bone staff. Interesting. Oh no, this is just a drop down to the set of stairs above our bonfire. I thought there was treasure up here. Maybe I'm mistaken and this is just a way out if you haven't bought a Pharos lockstone. Although, yeah, did that change in between Souls and Scholar? Because I notice now that this door is just open. I'm pretty sure this door required the Pharos Lockstone, same as that one, back in Vanilla. But then, yeah, they would have changed it in Scholar to allow you to come through here regardless, because they had added the statue in front of the Ruined Sentinel's door. So they needed to make sure there was definitely a way for you to progress through, even if you didn't have a fragrant branch. And that is this. I forget what that item is, but it's a hell of a drop to actually get it safely without dying. So we'll ignore it. We've already grabbed that item because we're in another place we've already been. That's right, we've made it back to the end. And pretty sure somewhere in my inventory we've already got a fragrant branch of yore, because we should have two at this point. Let's just pop up and talk to Strayed. Okay, we don't have one, so there's three we could have got at this point, surely. There's one in Malentia's shop. Well, I do know for sure where we can find another one. So maybe we'll go and grab that. And before we grab it, we'll just level up our shard because we've got the chance and spend a few of these souls. Because, for reasons, we're going to need 3 intelligence. Back in the wharf once again. There's a door. Well, there's a room we missed. And so we'll take care of it. God, I need to stop doing rolling attacks. I'm never intending to do rolling attacks. I'm just doing them because I'm an idiot. And those dart boys are also hanging around, which is annoying. Now, this is probably going to go badly. Oh no, it's not going terribly. That's actually working out quite well. Although now there's another lad coming down for some reason. Why are these dark lurker guys coming all the way up here? I'm not even sure if that's their name. In fact, it's not their name. Dark lurker is something else entirely. But they do lurk, and they like the dark. So yeah, let's have a little poke in this room. And we find lots of poison jars. Nasty old poison jars. We don't want them. But we do want whatever's in this chest. A fragrant branch, fantastic. And while we're here, whatever this is, we can grab as well. Nice. So there's the fragrant branch we were after, and now we will go back and meet our friend Strayed over in the Bastille. Let's see what happens if we push this here barrel off. Oh, it turns out we didn't even need to. Dude just straight up did it for us. Nice. Now, while we're up here, we could have another crack at that pursuer. Doesn't sound like a bad plan. He's a tricky little boy in this enclosed area, but we'll give it a go. Yeah, if he wants to do those powered up stabs, then I guess they're fine. And we know that sweeping is fine. Now this one though, hey, he did do the jumpy swoop, which means a free hit for us. Yeah, by the time we finish Scholar, we're going to be really good at fighting the pursuer. Although whether I could take on two of them at once is another question. Oh god, I'm getting greedy. Could have killed him without taking a hit if we hadn't got greedy.
It is a butcher's dog, mate.
But hey ho. Let's bob over here and deal with this archer boy that was annoying us down below. For we are indeed revenge. Dang right. We are indeed up above the bit where we came in. Over that way is the first bonfire. So it's all connected. And then this drops us back in where? Somewhere. It's not important. There is one more item up here, isn't there? Where is it? Or am I thinking of somewhere else where you can make a precarious jump? It might be here. Yeah.
Oh!
Flame butterfly and a torch, that's nice. That's pretty cool, in fact. And if we go along here, there is indeed another item. Good. This is all taking us away from where we need to be, but I like to clear up these items, you know. Soul of Brave Warrior and a golden wing shield. Pretty cool. The soul might come in handy. Question is, can we get back up?
No.
Once again, we return to this room, but this time we've definitely got a fragrant branch. I'd be glad when these guys are just despawned completely after 10 kills, because they're mildly annoying. But yeah, let's speak to this chap. Let's light the bonfire. Now let's speak to this chap.
Still a bit stiff, I'm afraid. I must thank you, young traveller. I've been a guest for a very long time.
He's strayed.
But I don't think that anybody will miss me. Very good indeed. Cursed one, weak you may be, but I, strength, will teach you my spells.
You see, this is why we got that 3 intelligence, so he'll actually talk to us and not just call us an imbecile. Although we can still learn the mock gesture, so we can still call other people imbeciles. But now, what have we got here? Could it be? Well, yeah, it is. I've just grabbed it, so obviously it is.
Cursed one. Do you really think you can manage the glories that are my spells?
I don't need the glories that are your spells, my friend. Not when I've got Allison. Here she is. And she's a beaut. Whoosh. Whoosh. Lovely. Bomp, big downwards blonks. Fantastic stuff.
Hey, that's right.
So we've got a new weapon in tow. We should probably go and see a blacksmith about levelling it up a bit. But we've got one right here in this zone, so let's go have a chat with Macduff. Right, we've just got her up to level 1 at the moment.
Dear flame.
But yeah, let's go test her out, shall we? Where should we go? Let's just see what these dogs think about it. Nice. That's good damage. 333 on that overhead smash.
333, 333, it's always 333.
I like it. It's not even that slow. And I don't think it's that heavy either. Let's see. Oh yeah, we got 62%. So it's quite heavy. But the point is, we can use it whilst using this armor, so that's all good. And we can open that door just so we can pop in and see Macduff like a civilized person if we need to. Now, if we're going to want better armor at any stage, we're definitely going to need more vit. So let's just pump a couple of points into that right now, while we've got the chance. Head back to the rise, and now we can kill this lad once again. Ooh, that's kind of cool. Didn't do a great deal of damage, but that's an interesting rolling attack. Stab. I like it. I like it a lot. And now we can end the episode in pretty much the same place we started it, but with a new toy. Look here. It's amazing. So yeah, next time round, we'll descend into the Sinner's Rise and test out Alice and see what she's capable of. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you soon. Thank you.